Alex asks, what are some of the positives of being a self-published author, and what are some of the negatives? And that's a great question, because a lot of people do wonder whether they should work with a publisher. And frankly, a lot of publishers are saying they don't want to work with small authors anymore. Major publishers want to work with authors who have large platforms, who can sell lots of books for them. And if you don't have 100,000 or so followers on your various email lists and social media channels, there's a good chance they either A, won't want to work with you, or B, will want you to buy somewhere in the neighborhood of $30,000 to $35,000 worth of books in order to justify their investment in you. So this isn't a particularly appropriate question. So again, what are some of the positives of being a self-published author? Okay, there actually are some. So the be-all and end-all is not necessarily working with a publishing house, although there are advantages there. But what are the advantages of being a self-published author? Lots. Okay, number one, you can set the price of your book, and you get to keep all of the money. If you went with a traditional publisher, you'd be splitting income with them, and there's a good chance if you sold 10,000 books, you wouldn't make more than $2,000 if you went with a publishing house. On the other hand, if you sold 10,000 books at $20 a piece, you'd have a good chunk of money. And if you went to the Kindle route and charge $2 or $3 a book, you'd still have a fair chunk of money, and it would all be yours. So what other benefits are there to being a self-published author? Again, there are many. You can choose the title of your book. You can choose the cover of your book. You can choose the back cover description of your book. You can decide whether to put ads in your book for your own services. You can really turn it into a big marketing machine for you, which is also a great benefit. And I think the other benefit is that you maintain all of the rights. And granted, you know, I don't think anyone's going to turn How to Write Your Book in the Flesh into a major motion picture anytime soon. But on the other hand, it very well could be a page-a-day calendar. It could be other licensed materials. Doesn't matter. I own the content. I own the copyright, and I can do whatever I want with it because let me back up on this. I work with a publishing company, so I still have the rights for that because we negotiated that. But as a self-published author, you would maintain all of those rights. If you went to a publishing house, you would have to negotiate for who owns what, which rights. Okay, so that answers, in some respects, the positives of being a self-published author. What are some of the negatives? Okay, that's a great question. You are in charge of everything. So you have to hire your content development editor like me. You need to, and what a content development editor does is looks over your book and sees where the strengths are and gives you a pat on the back and sees where the faults are and helps you realize what those are and gives you ideas on how to correct those faults and maybe even works with you and rewrites some of those or gives you tips on how to rewrite some of those. Also, you'll need to hire your own proofreaders and copy editors, which means you need to find proofreaders and copy editors who know what they're doing, and you'll have to pay them out of your own pocket. You'll also need to find layout and design people to design the front cover of your book and the interior pages of your book and the back cover of your book, and they better know what they're doing in order to get good placements on Amazon so the picture looks good when people see it on the Amazon page. Then you need to go to Kindle and upload the book on Kindle. That's not terribly hard. I've helped a number of clients do that with my coaching services. And you need to do other things to make the book stand out on Amazon. You need to do your own marketing, your own promotion, your own advertising, your own publicity, and pay for it yourself. So those are some of the downsides or the negatives. You know, you control the show, which is positive, but you have to pay for all the production. So that's something to consider. So those are some of the negatives. So Alex, I hope that answers your question.